Good morning, boys and girls. Good morning, boys and girls.
Good morning, Danny.
It's me, hashtag the real Danny, and my friend Gloogie here for another episode of Mr. Tom's Neighborhood.
We're so excited to be back with y'all this week, yeah.
Yeah, and this week we're teaching another Bible story. But first, Gloogie?
Yeah?
Are you okay?
Well, no. Now that you ask, Danny, I'm not doing so good.
Why not, Gloogie? What's the matter?
Well, I'm just kind of down and not feeling very good about myself because I'm just a little puppet monster, and I'm just not sure that God can use me for anything.
Oh, well, he can, Gloogie. He can use you for a lot of things. God can use all sorts of people to do good, wonderful things in the world.
Really? Are you sure? Because I'm kind of funny looking, and I don't have any hands.
Well, I think God can use you. You want to hear a story that reminds me of?
Yeah, that would be great. Maybe that made me feel better.
Okay. Well, this week, we're studying about Rahab. Remember last week when they sent the spies into the land?
Yeah?
Well, this week, we're sending spies into another place called Jericho to find out if we could beat the people from Jericho. Joshua sent some spies in, and a nice lady named Rahab helped them. But you know what? Rahab wasn't an important person. She was just a normal person who actually had a lot of sin in her life. But God used her, and she helped save the spies.
How did she do that?
Well, the spies went into her house, and she hid them, and then she let them escape the city with the news that the Jericho people were afraid of Joshua and God's people, and so that they could easily take the city with God's help. But Rahab used her house and her roof, and she hid them and let them escape so that they could take the message back to Joshua.
Wow! But she wasn't an important person?
No, she was just a normal person that had sin in her life, like we all do. But God was able to use her for a very important mission. And then God saved her family. And we'll find out about that when we learn about the Battle of Jericho next week.
Oh, yeah? So maybe God can use me. Do you think, are you sure God can use anybody?
Yeah.
What about this guy right here?
Oh, well, yeah, God can use him. That's fake Danny. Yeah, God can use him to do wonderful things. He's using him right now to do wonderful things.
Yeah? What about this guy?
Oh, yeah. Well, that's that bearded guy. God can use him, too. He does wonderful things through him for the Veterans Outreach, yeah.
And what about this guy? Wow, look at those mittens. Those are so neat. He's just sitting there looking all cool.
God can use anybody, even a man with mittens.
Well, but this is making me feel lots better, Danny. Thank you. So, boys and girls, remember, no matter if you don't think God can use you, he can use you for wonderful things, even me, because I don't have any hands.
Yeah, that's great. Boys and girls, remember, God can use you. Find ways to be used this week for God's purpose, and we'll see you all next week. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.